Good morning, everyone. I hope you've had a nice day yesterday, the first day, and hope that you will be looking forward to the rest of the 4 days with equal interest. Today, we are here to tell you about how the workshop is going to take place in December. How many of you have already attended our workshops? Okay, great. As participants or as remote center coordinators? Participants. So you generally have an idea of what the workshop will be like for the participant. But now you're on the other side of the fence, so you will have to be managing it. So we will be walking you through all the steps that are necessary for the workshop, your role as the workshop coordinator, as well as there is something for the remote center coordinator also. We have continuously been developing various steps which will make things easy for both you and us, and some of that involves software. So today I will be talking to you about the logistics. My colleague Jaya Gaitonde will be talking to you about the funds, and our software team here will be giving you a demonstration and a step-by-step walkthrough the software that you will be using during the workshop. Yeah, I will be talking about the introduction to the project and some history, then the various workshops that we have conducted, then obviously logistics, then the other two things which will be very, very important for the conduct of the workshop. So we started off in 2009, like Professor Fatak told you yesterday. This project started off targeting about 1,000 teachers at a time, but we quickly found out that we could definitely increase our scope and include more and more teachers who could benefit from this activity. In 2013, we were asked by the ministry to scale up to 10,000 teachers at a time. Obviously, the whole scale also increased from about 180 remote centers. We have now about 353 remote centers across the country. And in the second phase, IIT Kharagpur is the partner institution, and we have a mandate to train up to 1,50,000 teachers in the second phase. So far, since 2009, we have conducted 26 workshops on various engineering as well as non-engineering topics. Some very interesting ones like green buildings and solar photovoltaics, and a very interesting workshop on how to write good conference papers. Every topic that in some way or the other deals with a teacher and his or her performance in the classroom. That is what we have been trying to target. So I'm very happy to say that so far the workshops have been attended by over 90,000 participants and at 353 remote centers. Now we come to the actual logistics of the workshop. You all know that you have been called here so as to become cognizant with what you should expect during the main workshop. The 5 days that you spend here is actually a very compressed version of the main workshop. These faculty that you see here will be teaching these particular topics in the main workshop, and you, like Professor Fatak said yesterday, you will be the representatives of IIT Bombay there in your centers and will act as like teaching assistants or help the faculty here in IIT Bombay. If your participants have any problems regarding tutorials and things like that, you will be able to help them out. That is the whole idea of bringing you here and giving you such a strenuous kind of rigorous kind of a training here. So at the remote centers, we have the remote center coordinator who is normally in charge of all the logistics at your center. And then the second person is the workshop coordinator, who is normally a subject expert. And that person, as I said just now, is invited here for a rigorous training. And when you go back, you will be able to guide and solve the doubts of the participants. Now, there are cases where the remote center coordinator is also a workshop coordinator. several times. It's not necessary that the remote center coordinator is a completely different person. Especially in our workshops on computer science, we've had people come who also were faculty in computer science and were the workshop coordinators as well as the remote center coordinators. Then this is the framework that we will be using to relay the workshop live. We will be using the AVU. This is an ICT framework. It's a kind of a virtual classroom atmosphere which has been created by our partner institute, Amrita. And this will be used to deliver and transmit all live lectures at the remote centers. So if people who have already attended our workshops, maybe you could give an idea of what the workshop feels like. You will have the IIT Bombay faculty being relayed live in your classroom, and you will have people sitting and listening to the lectures, as well as at given intervals and periods, there will be interaction. So your participants, it has to be managed properly because we are expecting thousands of questions. It has to be managed properly, and your participants can actually interact live with the faculty here. So though it is in, I mean, though the participants are attending the workshop in your remote centers at a distance, it is very easy for them to ask questions to the faculty here in IIT, and the faculty will try to resolve the doubts. Now, this particular interaction is heard by all remote centers across the country. So even if one participant from one remote corner of India asks a question, the other participants can also listen to the question. So now your duty or your one of your jobs will be to make sure that the same question is not repeated again and again. That just takes up time. We have limited time. And if the same questions get, you know, repeated, the faculty also gets obviously irritated. So one of your jobs will be to collect all the questions and make sure that there are no repetitive questions. This is the other way of interaction with the participants. So we have face-to-face participation through AVU, and then we have another online kind of a interaction that is on Moodle. All of you are on Moodle. Have you all checked into your Moodle interface? Yeah. So when the participants actually start applying and they register and we confirm them, they will also be automatically given Moodle interface. So you will have participants registering onto Moodle and asking questions or clarifying their doubts and things like that. They will also be using the Moodle to submit their assignments. Okay. So these two components, the AVU component and Moodle component, are the two interfaces that we have for connecting with the participants. Now the logistics for the main workshop. Once you go back, we are planning to start the registration by 5th October. Now the registration will also have a list of all your remote centers. So the participant can choose which remote center he or she wants to attend the workshop in. We will advertise, we have a huge database of teachers. Yeah, around 1 lakh teachers we have on our database. We will be sending a mail to all of them, to their colleges. And we will also be sending you a soft copy of the brochure. You can print out copies of it and distribute them among the local colleges that you have around your area. Now, this particular feature, the RCC will be given an interface to fill in details of seating capacity and accommodation details. This particular point, the software team will be explaining to you. So, any remote center coordinators in this group? One. Okay. So, please do pay attention. This is a new feature. And we will be sending a mail regarding this to your remote center coordinators also. I request you all to please go back and make sure that your remote center coordinator fills in this capacity and accommodation details. Otherwise, the name of your remote center will not show in the list. So this has to have, this has to be done by a deadline. We will tell you what the deadline is, but make sure that your remote center coordinator fills in this particular detail. Otherwise, the name of your remote center will not show up in the list, in the registration list when participants want to register. There is another component which will be explained to you in that software demonstration that we have, and that particular component concerns you specifically. You are expected to fill the attendance online, and the team will explain to you how it is to be done. I have already talked to you about this. The remote center coordinator will have to fill in capacity, seating capacity, accommodation, and as I said, this information will be visible to the participants. I'm going to explain the registration process to you now. The participants will be asked to provide a letter of approval. All of you were also asked to do that. You had to bring or submit a nomination letter. This particular project is open only for teachers who are in employment. This is the reason we ask them to get a permission letter. So you will be asked to check the permission letter when they come. They will also be submitting the permission letter online when they register on our website, and we will be checking it, and only then will they be verified. That is, that particular step is called verification. We will be verifying them. Then a shortlist, it will be displayed on our website, as well as it will be sent to you all also. And the selected participants, we will be displaying your phone numbers, yours and the remote center coordinator's phone numbers, for them to contact you in case they need accommodation, etc. You will be asked to make arrangements for lodging and boarding. It's not mandatory. If you have the lodging, if you have hostels or guest houses, you can provide them. There is a certain component separately made under the budget for that particular expenditure. Now, you all agree with me that AVU is very, very important. If your AVU testing is not properly done, if your equipment is not in order, if your if you do not get the picture clearly at your center or the audio clearly at your center, the whole workshop will be a flop. If the participant cannot hear what is happening, then what is the point in that? Also, yesterday, as Professor Kannan has already announced, there has been a grant of funds to all the remote centers. So we expect that you, your centers will be in perfect order where the AVU is concerned. The AVU has to be perfectly in order so that the workshop is successful. We will provide the Moodle IDs for all the participants. Then we'll also give you the Creative Commons license and permission slips. You will have to get it done on the very first day. As you all know, we record the proceedings of all the workshops that we have and release them on our website in open source. So we need permission from all the people who are recorded. You know, we have to take their permission to release their content in open source. So you will have to do that. The inaugural and valedictory functions will be held in IIT Bombay, and they will be transmitted live. However, if you want to invite your own you know, dignitaries to attend, you may do so, but do stick to the schedule that we give you. We have said that yesterday also, that we are very, very particular about time here, and we will start exactly on time whatever happens. Okay. We will also provide you a list of phone numbers with different activities against them. Like, for example, if your participant has a problem with Moodle, they will be the number of the person who handles Moodle in IIT. You can call that person, and that person will resolve your problem. So we'll have helplines for the Moodles, for software, for administration, for funds. So there will be helplines. Yeah, quizzes and assignments will be held on Moodle. Please disregard IIT Bombay X. That platform we will not be using in your workshop. Now, post main workshop, the faculty from IIT will give the participants a 2-week assignment that they have to do. And Yeah, they will be given the final assignment at the end of the workshop, and they will be given 2 weeks to complete that assignment. And we need that 2 week window so that we can finish the attendance and, you know, make certificates and all that. And we request you all to monitor the assignments. Since you will already be in touch with them, you will be on Moodle with them, you will be able to monitor their assignments easily. Now, this is the criteria for certificates. This is a fully funded workshop. We expect the participants to fulfill all these criteria, and only then will they be given the certificate. Please make sure that you tell your participants this. We, of course, will display this on the website, but on the very first day, we request you all also to tell them this. I will be sharing this presentation with you all also. They have to have at least 90% attendance. They have to complete all the assignments on Moodle and completion of the workshop assignments. I don't think that's a very big requirement, isn't it? So they have to do all these things. I'm saying 90% because people do have emergencies and we have that little window so that if there is a problem, they can take a day off. So post main workshop, once we look at all the assignments, once your attendance is submitted, once everything is done, then T10KT will distribute participation certificates to all the eligible participants, and we will publish all the content that we have generated during this workshop, the slides, the assignments, the questions, everything will be on the portal. When we say attendance, we have a feature in the AView which monitors attendance in all your classrooms. We can actually see your classrooms. We have had cases in the past where where workshop coordinators have sent us full attendance for, like, say 60 people, 70 people. But in the AView snapshot, we actually take snapshots which tell you what time the picture has been taken and how many people were there. There have been discrepancies to the order of, say, where a class has registered something like 60 participants, there were hardly 4 people in the classroom, or there were none. So this is a way that we have formulated. In the distance mode, we have to have some sort of way to monitor attendance, and we will be doing this. So you make sure that your camera is positioned properly, and we have to have a clear picture of all the participants present in the classroom. So we will be using the AView monitoring tool in our attendance monitoring, and we will be giving the attendance that we collect to the funds, to the accounts team, and they will release whatever, they will clear your, you know, settlements and all that based on the attendance. So please remember that you give us a correct attendance. Yes.
Yeah, if people don't attend, what's my role in this as a workshop?
You mark them absent.
Okay, so it's...
Yes, you mark them absent. I will not hold you responsible.
Oh, okay. That's what I was thinking.
Yeah. See, if they are absent, they miss out on the certificate.
Yeah.
As simple as that.
Okay. So if there are none, so I'll just put none. If there are four people, I'll just put four people.
We just want the correct figures.
Okay.
Is there any limit for amount of participants?
We expect a minimum of 30 at every center, and maximum according to your capacity.
The participant will directly apply to your website.
Yeah, the application is on the NMEICT IIT Bombay website.
Okay, so
your role begins only when we send the list to you.
Okay.
Only then.
Who will be the participant? Who are eligible to attend this workshop?
I have just talked about it.
It is a website. It is mentioned in the website.
Yes, it will be mentioned on the website.
How to get that site?
It's the same site that you applied on.
Okay, same site. Thank
yes.
you very much. Thank
you. Unfortunately, 20 members are registered.
That is fine.
Then attendance will continue or not?
That is fine.
That will be decided by you, that is not our.
Yeah.
For example, in our situation, we won't get any participant over there. Then what will be the situation?
We will think about that.
Okay.
Ma'am, I have a question.
Yes.
Can we send the brochures to teachers who are, means professors who are teaching in BSc colleges?
I just said that teachers teaching in UG colleges are not allowed. UG is applicable only to engineering colleges, not science colleges. Okay.
Madam, the staff members teaching chemistry subject and other subjects are
If they want to attend physics,
yes.
Absolutely fine. They are all interconnected.
Okay.
No
okay.
problem.
Excuse me, ma'am. Can any engineering branch faculty can attend this apart from basic sciences like physics, chemistry? Okay.
I'm just repeating myself now. Yes.
The PG, the teachers who are teaching UG degree or PG with the MPhil qualification, and the subject taught in physics is more or less equivalent to the what we are teaching in engineering colleges.
Yes.
In that case, we can allow the UG teachers to participate in this workshop.
If that particular college is also a PG center.
Yes, yes, it is yes. there. Okay, thank you very much.
As far as the subject is concerned, I think that this rule must be modified, because what yes. we are studying here, that is not even the 20%.
So at least for this subject, especially for physics, chemistry and mathematics, I think, this is my opinion, this is not, but it should be modified, because the BSc syllabus is far, far above than that of what we teach in BA first year.
I'll definitely
so please,
try to find
please see
out
to it.
And
yes.
I will not be able to see to it.
No, no.
It is not my role to see to it, but I'll definitely convey your opinion to Professor Fatak and he can find out.
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
I think you allow BSc teachers also, those who are teaching in undergraduate, so we can get more participants.
I think yeah. we are wasting our time. It's not about getting more participants, it's about participants who are eligible to attend. UG teachers are not eligible, and I think this is my final word on it now. I will not entertain questions about this now. Yeah, if there is any other question.
Regarding the assignment, we have to check it and then mark, how do we evaluate the assignment?
You don't have to evaluate the assignment. You just have to make sure that they have completed the assignment and posted it on Moodle.
But you have given this final assignment time 2 weeks. So,
yes.
I mean.
So, you can be in touch with them on Moodle.
Okay.
That is why we have given Moodle. You and the participants both will be on the Moodle. So, you will be able to monitor whether they have completed or not. And you have their contact numbers, so it is up to you how you contact them, whether you contact them by email
or they can contact me as well, probably.
Yes.
Okay.
But you have to impress upon them that they have to complete it, otherwise there is no
point of actually going through this.
Yeah. So, this was the logistics component, and I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all the stakeholders in this particular project that we have been conducting for so many years now. MHRD for giving us the generous fund to carry out this project, Amrita University for the AVU, Indian Society for Technical Education, which gives you the certificate, and of course all the remote centers. Without you all, it wouldn't have been possible at all.
Good morning and welcome to the presentation on financial support for the engineering physics main workshop. The outline of the financial procedure can briefly be described in 3 steps: fund transfers, fund utilization, and final settlement. Let's begin with fund transfers by IIT Bombay. For fund transfers, we require the bank details of all the remote centers. So most of the remote centers have already provided their details, so they need not provide them again unless there are any changes. The new centers will have to provide their bank details in this format: the bank name, address of the bank, IFSC code of the bank, account number, and account name. The details have to be uploaded online on the NMEICT website. Please note that the bank account has to be your official bank account of the institute, and it should not be in any personal name. We will accept the bank details without any liability on our part. We will start the fund transfers after the registration is closed, and we will complete them before the main workshop starts. The funds will be transferred through NEFT, and the fund transfer details will be updated on NMEICT website against your RC ID. The remote center coordinator, workshop coordinator, and institute head will receive an auto-generated mail from us giving all the details of fund transfers. Also, the institute head and remote center coordinator will have access to view fund transfer details pertaining only to their remote center. The RCs will then check the actual amount credited in the bank account, and they will acknowledge receipt online on the website. Now we come to the fund utilization. Funds have to be utilized as per the budget heads and the utilization guidelines provided by IIT Bombay. Inter-head fund adjustments are not permitted. The budget sheet, the sheet has been given to you. Please, you can refer to it. The chart is self-explanatory and it is in two parts, a fixed cost and a variable cost. Under fixed cost, we have three subheads: honorarium to your workshop team members, miscellaneous expenses, and institute expenses. The RCs will select their honorarium budget column based on the number of participants. Honorarium payments by cash is strictly not permitted. It has to be either by checks or by bank transfers. So please make sure that all your team members, including support staff, have their bank accounts in place. A team member should not play more than one role and should not claim multiple types of remunerations, except for RCC. If RCC is an expert in the subject, RCC can also be a workshop coordinator, and in this case, the honorarium is clubbed to ₹20,000. The next subhead under fixed cost is miscellaneous expense budget. This is provided for the registration kits to be purchased for the participants, stationery, postage, printing, photocopy charges, chartered accountant fees, and other workshop-related contingent expenses. The third subhead under fixed cost is institute expense budget. This is ₹10,000 per remote center. This amount has to be transferred to your institute account for the common facilities provided by your institute for the workshop. The next part of the budget is the variable cost. Under variable cost, you have food, accommodation, and travel reimbursement. All remote centers will have to arrange lunch and tea for their participants as well as for their team members. Accommodation is optional and can be arranged as per availability at your center. Travel reimbursement is also for outstation participants. The criteria for travel reimbursement is that the distance between the participant's place to the remote center has to be more than 100 kilometers one way. Each remote center will calculate their own variable cost depending on the number of participants. So the total workshop cost per remote center will be the fixed cost entitlement as shown in the budget sheet plus the actual variable cost. Now we come to the final settlement. After the workshop gets over, all remote centers will prepare final settlement in the formats provided by IIT Bombay. There will be two main documents, utilization certificate and receipt and payment statement, and there will be some supporting annexures. Both these documents have to be printed on your institute letterhead and they have to be signed by both the coordinators. The final settlement has to be certified by a chartered accountant. CA certification is mandatory and it is our audit requirement. All the settlement document formats along with the utilization guidelines will be mailed to you before the main workshop. The final settlement documents along with original bills have to be submitted within 1 month after the workshop gets over. The final settlement is subject to audit by IIT Bombay. The certificates of both the coordinators, that is the remote center coordinator and workshop coordinator, will be released only after the final settlement is properly completed by the remote center. This is our accounts team, and they'll be liaising with you during the fund transfers and for the final settlement. These are the contact details for fund related queries. These details are also available on our website. Thank you very much and best wishes for the main workshop. Yes, if you have any questions, yeah.
Can you get a copy of this presentation so that we
can No, the guidelines will be mailed to you. Yeah. Or no, we will be mailing it to you. Yeah. Along with fund transfer, the auto-generated mail, all these guidelines will come to you. And the final settlement document formats also. So the auto-generated mail which comes for the fund transfer details will have all the information and the formats of final settlement documents.
Who is going to be responsible, workshop coordinator or the RCC coordinator?
The remote center coordinator, but workshop coordinator has to sign the documents.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Only when minimum of 10 participants are there, am I correct?
Yes, we have provided that column, but that will be decided later on whether you will be allowed to hold a workshop at your remote center if you have less than 10 or maybe. Maybe Mukta will be able to answer this question.
The minimum rule only if your remote center is remote in the true sense. Only if you are in a really remote corner of India and you have just maybe one or two engineering colleges around you. Only then we can think of relaxing that particular minimum figure. We have gone up to say 5 or 10, but only in that case.
No, no, it's purely with the participant to register themselves with any of the remote centers. Am I correct? So it is not the question of whether the remote center is located at the remote area or not.
If your remote center is in a city and there are 5 other remote centers in that particular place and all the other remote centers have more participants than you and you have less than 10, then we will shift the participants to the other colleges and not run your remote center.
Fine. Okay.
Madam?
Yes.
When will you receive the participant certificates?
Participant certificates, you have to certify the attendance.
Yeah.
And then send it to us. They will look at the fund settlement and only then we will send
Then
it.
We will send them through poster.
Yes. We will send it to you, the participant.
Yeah, yeah. What I'm saying, after receiving from you, we will send through poster to them.
I think
who will bear that cost?
The postage budget is inclusive in miscellaneous expenses.
No, we will put that one in that miscellaneous.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Earlier we have to put. That means earlier we have to put that budget in miscellaneous.
So before the settlement, so you can include it in the settlement.
So you have mentioned that the attendance, that is very important.
Yes.
So suppose when we are submitting the expenditure for outstation participants, you have mentioned that you will pay 300 rupees per day.
Yes.
So will this be related with the attendance of the participant? This 300 rupees per day. Suppose if the attendance is poor, you will not be giving the certificates. So that is okay. But what about this expenditure of 300 per day if the participant is absent for some days?
Obviously, the accommodation money will have to be deducted, right?
So after the, yes. I am asking,
but then
madam,
they will be paying, no?
Because
to the hostel.
There should be no dispute after completion of this workshop,
yeah.
The main workshop. For that I am asking.
The travel reimbursement has to be paid.
No,
on the last
not about
day.
Travel
so
reimbursement.
If the
participant is coming, then we will pay the travel reimbursement.
Yeah.
But if he remains absent, if you take the snapshots, suppose 60 participants have registered and only 40 are present.
Come in between and then they come. On
So in that case.
But they don't come. So if you have incurred the expenses, maybe you can include in the settlement.
After that, there will be no problem from your side, no madam?
No.
So that is important.
But we do expect you to go and find out why the participant hasn't come.
We will do our best, no doubt about it.
Yeah.
But still, that is a matter of money.
Yes.
So otherwise, we will put ourselves in difficulty.
If the participant doesn't turn up, you can try and cancel the accommodation.
Yes, please go ahead and cancel the accommodation.
Cancel the accommodation.
If that participant is absent for more than 2 days, we will cancel him from the course.
Yeah.
Is it?
So obviously, the accommodation will also be cancelled.
Thank you.
Good morning, yes. Madam. My question is, in small cities like ours, Belgaum in Karnataka state, the radial distance from our college is about 10 kilometers. So we treat them as urban area and people will come from there. But some people from 60 kilometers away staying in rural colleges, if they attend, if TA will be given, that will be far better. It is my request to convey it to sir.
So actually it is more than 100 kilometers one way, so
we can't.
Yeah.
That's why if it is conveyed and some modification would be done, that would be fine.
This is the last workshop we are conducting. We don't want to make
last,
any changes
last funded
now.
Workshop.
Thank you.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
You are saying that this is the last funded project. Other day, I think yesterday, one professor was telling that we have to charge rupees 1,000 per participant.
That is a funded workshop model, but it is not applicable to this workshop on engineering physics.
Okay.
We will be starting that model from next year.
Not for this.
Not okay. For this. Yours is the last one.
Okay.
Attention to this, because this software model we are going to be following very closely, and we will not be able to entertain your request to manually upload data and things like that. So please make sure you understand this thoroughly. You will also be getting actual hands-on experience today afternoon when we have the lab sessions. Half of you will be going to the physics lab and the other half will be doing practice for this, because we'll have to interchange the two parts. I mean, we will be dividing you into two parts this afternoon, and one part will be doing the physics lab and the other part will be doing the software practice, and we will interchange afterwards. So do make sure that you pay attention and understand this component. I have with me my colleague Rachna Shiriskar and Kanan. They will be explaining this particular component to you, and we also have Aruna. Aruna, she is the project manager on the NME ICT software team, and Dipesh and Abhinaya, they are the team members you will be interacting with during the when you use this particular component. So if you have any questions, please definitely clear them today only.
Thank you, ma'am. First, we will begin with the important points. The first is to sign up at IITB NME ICT website, which you have already done registration during your as a workshop coordinator. If a remote center coordinator, for the remote center coordinator, he will has to sign up using the same email ID which he has given in the nomination form submitted to IIT Bombay. If a remote center coordinator wants to become a workshop coordinator, then he will have to use a different email ID. Similarly, if a remote center coordinator wants to become a participant, he will again have to use a different email ID before signing. We will see the roles of a workshop coordinator and a remote center coordinator. First, we will begin with the role of the remote center coordinator. Earlier, we used to send emails with a link to fill the sitting capacity. With this module, the sitting capacity will be filled in this interface. So when the remote center coordinator logins on our IITB NME ICT website, he will see the following on the screen: workshops attended, manage remote center capacity, view participants and program schedule. In the workshops attended, he will see all the workshops he has attended earlier with the details of the workshop. Under the manage remote center capacity, he will have to fill the available seats and available accommodation. These things he will have to fill before the starting of the registration of the main workshop. So what if a remote center coordinator doesn't fill the sitting capacity? If this sitting capacity is not filled, your institute will not be reflected in the registration form to the participant. This remote center capacity details will have to be filled only once by the remote center coordinator. For any updation or any change, the remote center coordinator will have to contact IIT Bombay through email or through phone. On this same interface, he will find view participants and program schedule. So he can view and download the schedule of the main workshop. Also, he can view the registered participants for the main workshop. We will see the roles of the workshop coordinator. When the workshop coordinator logins on our IITB NMEICT website, he will see the following on his screen: workshops attended, manage attendance and view program schedule. Again, the workshops attended, he will see all the workshops which he has attended earlier. In the manage attendance and program schedule, he can view and download the schedule. Attendance will be available on the workshop day itself, on the workshop day itself, on the first day, then later on it will be available. There are two important things which a workshop coordinator has to remember and he has to do. The first thing, he will have to download the attendance of the participants every day before the start of the workshop. He will have to print this attendance. He will have to take signature of the participants. Then he has to scan, and this scan he has to do in PDF format, and he has to upload this attendance on the interface. The other thing is marking the attendance. So when the workshop coordinator logins in his interface, when he clicks on manage attendance and view program schedule, he will see a list of participants. Against the list of participants, there will be checkbox and update button. So the workshop coordinator, if he wants to mark a participant present, he will have to click on the checkbox. So for all the participants whom you want to mark present, you will mark them, you will click on the checkbox, and below down the page there will be an update all button. So after clicking on that button, all the participants attendance will be marked. So now if the workshop coordinator wants to update attendance of a single participant, he can update it against the participant's name. Attendance should be marked every day. If the attendance is not marked within 48 hours of the workshop, the participant will get an email that his attendance is absent. So this is very important that before 48 hours of the workshop, you will have to maintain the attendance, and you will have to do this attendance, otherwise an email will be sent to the participants.
Upload this attendance, let's say after finishing, like whatever you are doing here, after every, I take the attendance during every course that is running, then I go back, and then at the end of the day, I put up the attendance for the whole day.
Yes.
Now that will save the attendance automatically in your website.
Yes.
What I'm asking is that, do I have to send the scanned copy of it immediately in the same day, or I can just wait for the end of it, because you have already the attendance available in our website?
No, that upload attendance button,
the signature,
that
signature
will be available the workshop date, the workshop end date, and after that 2 more days. And it is good that you do it every day, so that it is convenient for you. Later on it will be too much. Every day we have to do.
Okay, so there will be only, I have to send the scanned PDF copy
once in
a day. Yeah. Not 4 times.
No, not 4 times.
Okay, that would have been absolutely.
Yeah. So you have to download the attendance day wise, because it will have a date. So every day you have to download an attendance, mark it. You have to take the signature of the participants, because you have to fill the attendance online. So you would anyways require to see who are absent and present. End of the day, mark the participants as present and upload the PDF file every day. These two activities have to be done every day.
So I'm asking different. If the student is present for 50% day, 50% time he was absent, so he will be marked absent or present?
Mark, we are taking session-wise attendance.
Okay, this is session-wise.
Yes. So you have to mark the participant present only for the sessions in which he or she is present.
No, the online one, is it session wise?
Online and the PDF both. We take 4 session, 4 time attendance in a day. We will be showing you a demo, and you will be also having
it
a hands-on. So
all the 4 session on a single sheet? Or
Yeah.
In a single sheet,
yeah.
Yes. We will be showing you
in
a demo.
We will soon show you a demo.
By default, the attendance will be absent.
Excuse me.
So when you click on the checkbox,
there are no four sheets. It's a single sheet for all four sessions of the day.
Okay.
One single sheet.
Okay.
And one on the interface.
No,
so there are two steps.
Okay. Now, if you are going to demonstrate it, then obviously we can just wait for that.
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
Maybe.
Can't I download the attendance sheet of all the days in one go?
No, sir. If the participant is absent, probably not attending, we get emails. We mark them absent. I mean, we mark them cancelled. So the name will be away from the attendance sheet.
That is by default. I can do that by manually.
Sir, we are very cynical at IIT Bombay. We know that workshop coordinators mark people who are present. So we have to take all precautions, unfortunately.
Yes, online is there, offline is there. Online is absent, offline is present. What is
present? Then you will be required to give an explanation.
That is online is at the time we will put that. Offline mode, end of the session, we can treat that. What we'll do at the time?
So by mistake, you have done some...
Manipulate or anything.
While filling the attendance, the respective date, from that respective date, 2 days you have to update it. So you yourself can update it.
Your point of view, two are there. Online is there, offline is there. Sometimes it may not coincide with the offline and online.
No, sir. See, you will obviously, when you mark the attendance, you will see the scan copy and see who all are present, and then you will mark the checkbox.
Unfortunately, that mistake was happened in online mode.
So for that, you have an update button.
Okay.
Suppose if you make a mistake, you can go back and update. Suppose the workshop starts on 8th of December.
Okay.
So the attendance of 8th December will be available till 10th December.
Okay.
You can make changes of 8th December till 10th December. After that, you can write an email to us. We will make the changes.
Okay, fine.
So this is the remote center coordinator's interface. Once you log into the system, we'll have three things. One is manage remote center capacity. That's the first thing you're going to do. So the remote center is going to do this for the remote center coordinator. So after logging into the system, you can fill the available seats and available accommodation by clicking on the details, this manage button. So you can fill the seating capacity and the available accommodation for your remote center. If you don't have any accommodation available, you can just enter it as zero. And after filling it, you will see this way. For editing this, you have to mail e-outreach or the concern team for updating the available accommodation and the available seats. So, view participants and program schedule. You can see the schedule here. You can also print the schedule from click here button. You can view the list of participants from this view button for your particular remote center. This is what a remote center coordinator can do. And we will proceed to the workshop coordinator's login. So for this workshop coordinator login, with the same email ID you have registered for this particular engineering workshop, you will be able to see this page. See, if you are a workshop coordinator for 1 week IST coordinator's workshop on engineering physics, with the same email ID, you should log in. You will be able to see the workshop coordinator's interface for this particular workshop. You will not be able to see the other workshops conducted by IIT Bombay for the engineering physics 2 weeks workshop, you will be able to see this workshop coordinator's interface. So this will say, like, on the start day of workshop, you will be able to see the details. If it is not, then you will be able to see will be available soon. You will not be able to see the attendance module till the start date of the workshop. While clicking on it, you can see different colors. Like, the blue colors will be enabled. You can update the blue color dates. And the gray color will be disabled. The buttons will be disabled. So you cannot update for the workshop. So for example, for 7th, it was yesterday's. So for yesterday, you can update the attendance sheet. First of all, you click here to download the attendance sheet. You will be able to see the list of participants of your workshop and the sessions available. So you can take the signatures from here and you can scan it later and upload it. And this is for a particular date. You have to download this thing for every day. So you can mark the attendance for that day and you can click on the update button. So on update, you will get a alert box updated successfully and the button will turn into green so that you can ensure that you have updated the person properly. Say for example, you have mistakenly done it, unchecked it. So it will turn into blue. So make sure before you leave the page and you also have an update all button. So you can update the attendance of all the participants in a single go. So all your buttons will be green in color. So if you're leaving, just in case you have, you know, unchecked the person unknowingly, you will always have this blue color thing. So you ensure that you have press, you know, checked the thing properly before leaving. So all your buttons before you leave will be green in color. That ensures that you have submitted the attendance and the database is updated. So while navigating to the next, you will always have this. Please make sure the changes are saved. Okay, if it is not saved, please click on the button. And this will be available for the present day as well. So after 48 hours or the day is not functioning, like tomorrow is September 9th, you will not be able to see the update button. The thing is, you have to update the participants' attendance before 48 hours of the day. For example, 9th will be open on tomorrow and it will be available till 11th of September. We will be having this hands-on session in the afternoon. So if you have any queries, you can just ask us. And you can upload the scanned attendance sheet of that particular day here by selecting the date in a PDF format. You can also see the schedule of the workshop available here. It's like the remote center coordinator's interface. You can also print this for your purposes. This is the workshop coordinator's interface. If you have any queries, yes, the schedule will be available on the Moodle also. So you can download the schedule from various places for printing. Do you have any queries of this workshop coordinator's interface?
In the very first slide, you have said the number of participants. The number of participants is the maximum capacity of the participants of the institute, or it is the registered participants?
It is the registered and confirmed participant.
Registered, okay.
Yeah.
Fine. Thank you.
This is not the remote center capacity.
No, I think
the very first one. The very first one. RC coordinators.
That refers to the number of seats you can offer in your remote center.
That is the max I am calling. Yes. I mean, it is not the actual number of the registered participants, I suppose. Okay, fine.
That is the number of seats you can offer to the participants.
That's right. Okay, thank you.
We just mark
attendance for a particular candidate, and by mistake I have just unchecked it. Can I just update it on the same day itself?
Yes.
Same day itself.
Yes, you can. And one more thing, if you're not updating the attendance before 48 hours, a mail will be sent to all the participants who were marked absent. So make sure that you update the attendance within 48 hours.
Please just describe how to sign up for the workshop coordinator login.
You don't have to sign up as a workshop coordinator. You have actually signed up already. You have come here by registering on the site.
That will work.
Yes.
Yes. Only remember the email ID that you have signed up with. Only that email ID we will recognize. No other email ID we will.
No. Right now we are signing with as a participant in this workshop.
Yes.
Next, the same ID will be work for the workshop coordinator.
But you have registered as a participant for the workshop coordinator's workshop.
Yeah.
So we have already recognized you as the workshop coordinator.
Okay.
So the same email ID we will recognize when you sign up for this.
Okay. Next time we will see this particular screen. Right?
Yes.
But okay. Please do remember the email ID that you have signed up with. We will not recognize any other one.
Thank you, madam.
Ma'am, online we have to update after each session and PDF at the end of the day or?
Not necessarily. You can update it at the end of the day whenever you are comfortable with.
Means online we have to mark at the end of the day for all four sessions.
It is up to you. It is up to you. It is optional whether you want to mark it exactly during the session or at the end of the day. It's up to you. But definitely at the end of the day.
What is the deadline for that uploading? On the same day or up to next morning?
Sir, that shows you have not been paying attention. 48 hours.
Ma'am, one small request. A tentative schedule for main workshop, our engineering physics is 8 to 18 December.
Yes.
But many of my colleagues that has been already registered for INOOF workshop, those are also holding in IIT Bombay from 16 to 18 December. So my request is that if we have slightly change of mention.
The faculty involved in engineering physics are extremely busy people. We have been able to get them very luckily. They have actually manipulated the date several times already according to their busy schedule. Now we cannot change them, unfortunately.
Yeah, madam. I don't want to divert with this question regarding a finance problem. Let us consider 10 to 15 members are there. For that 58,000 mentioned here. So after the authorization with the CA, if we provide the bills, is it a total bulk amount is provided to the bank account of the institute, or will you provide account pay checks? No. After this one, assume now 58,000 eligibility is there 10 to 15 strength.
Yeah.
Okay. This is a problem of after getting 58,000 is there.
Yeah.
Now at the time we are eligible the 58,000.
Yes.
So that amount will be credited to the institute account or will we provide different people are there here, their account numbers. That if you transfer that, if the transparency was not there, this is the only on paper they'll show that these many people are there, these are the workers. Then what we do for that? Suppose if I am the coordinator, workshop coordinator.
I am not getting your question.
No. Yeah. You are saying now the total amount will be credited to the institute account.
Oh, yeah.
That is advance amount only. So after that, we have to put total bills.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. See, we will estimate, we will check how many participants are registered at your place.
Okay.
And then we will estimate the total cost.
Okay.
And we will transfer it to your bank account of your institute. And then you can withdraw from that bank account and then distribute.
For that only I'm asking, madam. Here you put a workshop coordinator, system administrator, some are there.
Yeah.
For that, no need of account numbers of that people.
No, but you will have to send us the check copies.
Okay, that I am asking now.
Yes.
Okay, fine.
In the settlement, then you have to send us the check copies.
Yes, photocopies of check. Okay, for that only I am asking.
Yeah. Madam, yeah. Yes, I'm just a workshop coordinator. So probably with that logic, I should not be asking question anymore. But still I'm asking because obviously maybe in some day I'll be a coordinator myself, so it's not a bad idea to learn all these things. So I just want to ask you, there are certain heads and certain amount of money has been allotted regarding the which person is being chosen, like system administrator and so.
Yes.
So, do you need a kind of certificate? I mean, how do you, I mean, whether I'm really used a system administrator or not, do you need a kind of any authentication of that kind of stuff?
Yes.
So, yes. If you have not used, then don't pay, and there'll be an annexure.
No, let's say we have used, but then we have to, we want to pay that person that money.
Yes.
So, do you need any kind of authentication that we really use that person?
No. What authentication?
We are hoping you're a decent person. Oh, no, 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 ma'am. Yeah, no, no, no. You should not be hoping anything, okay? I am a decent person anyway. So, no, I mean, yeah, so I think we should not be judging each others. I'm not talking about that. Yeah, so I'm asking a very simple question. You just, do you need the authentication of it or?
We don't need an authentication that you have actually used a system administrator, but before the workshop starts, we expect you to send us a list of all the people who are involved in the workshop. Okay, and you will also be issuing a check in the name of that person that whom you have mentioned in the list.
Okay.
So we will need a copy of that check.
So that has to be signed by the head of the institute or the coordinator?
The remote center coordinator, head of the institute and the workshop coordinator.
Okay. All three person has to just sign and then it will be.
Yes.
इस आंसर को मैं थोड़ा सा एलिबरेट मैडम
एक्सक्यूज मी
राइट
जस्ट अ मिनट प्लीज
इफ इट्स अ बैंक ट्रांसफर देन यू गिव अस द डिटेल्स बैंक ट्रांजैक्शन नंबर
एवरीथिंग हैज टू बी डन ओनली थ्रू चेक्स एंड बैंक ट्रांजैक्शन देयर इज नो एक्चुअल कैश इन्वॉल्वड या
मैं इस क्वेश्चन का आंसर थोड़ा और एलिबरेट करना चाहूंगा कि ये जो जो आपने बाइफर्केशन दे रखा ना सिस्टम एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर चाहिए सपोर्ट स्टाफ चाहिए जब हम कोई इवेंट ऑर्गेनाइज कर रहे हैं तो बिना लोगों के करेंगे कैसे सिस्टम एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर के बिना ऑनलाइन एक्टिविटी होगी कैसे ही हैज टू बी देयर ही इज ए पार्ट ऑफ योर टीम सो इट इज नॉट एक्सपेक्टेड कि आपने उसको काम में लिया या नहीं लिया ये तो चॉइस है ही नहीं यू हैव टू बी राइट
Absolutely. You need a system administrator for this online activity for Moodle. And you need an AVU administrator to run your AVU for you. So we have taken into account all these heads so that you can run the workshop comfortably.
You will transfer this amount to the one account of college or we will open a separate account for this purpose?
No, your college must have already opened.
No, no. The thing is, you will send to the our college principal account, some account will be there.
Yes.
So that account is sufficient or for this purpose only on the name of three members. Because you are saying that we, three members will have to sign. But in college account, we are not signing.
No, you have to take the money from your college. So yeah. That is your internal how to take.
Then how to give the checks?
The three signatures will be on the utilization certificate.
Not on the checks. Yeah,
not
yeah.
on the checks.
But previously people said that you have to sign the three members.
No.
The
checks,
three members
checks.
Have to sign on the utilization certificate.
Hello? You don't have to sign the checks. The checks will be signed by the signatories. But you make sure that the checks are signed and given to the right person.
If there are no questions, then we will end this session.